is known as adjusting the microphone. These types of videos have become my favourite to do at the minute due to the fact that I'm having some visual issues, mainly with my eyes. So staring at the camera for too long sort of strains my eyes a little bit. So I've taken to writing stuff down on paper and doing the whispered audio. Hopefully you enjoy. This is part two of our, let's write it down. Last night we had the first lot of second legs of the Champions League quarterfinals. I watched the PSG Bayern Munich game, and it's got to be said, how weak is that Bayern Munich squad? Not the starting 11, and when they're all fit, obviously there's better players on the bench. But I was like, bring somebody on, and the only player they could bring on with any like experience really at that level was Javi Martinez. Absolutely crazy. Anyways, let's get started with this video today. We've already covered part one, in where we talked about, just having a sip of coffee, where we talked about Jadon Sancho. Possible transfers at the end of the season and where they could go. We have 8 more transfer talks or transfer targets to discuss. I'm starting to put Sky Sports News on board. City. That goes without saying. But he's already confirmed he'll be leaving at the end of the season. As has Pep Guardiola, he's also confirmed this. Now, in my opinion, and I'm not a Man City fan, but this is when I think Sergio Aguero should have left.
Honest.
couple of seasons working alongside Arteta whilst Arteta was Pep's assistant at Man City. So no doubt Arteta knows how to get the best out of Aguero. Would Aguero go there and walk straight into the team? They have, like I said, always been linked with a move. They have Aubameyang not really lived up to this season. If anything, he's become the new Mesut Ozil in terms of his wages and constant rumours of Arsenal not being happy with him. Would he go to Arsenal and improve them? Definitely up front. Arsenal would be improved if you give them 15 league games with Aguero and 15 league games with Aubameyang on this season's form. For Aubameyang anyway, I'd say Aguero is your better bet. But I don't think he's good. In all honesty, I believe wherever he goes, he will be a big part player. He's not going to go to a club and be a 30 to 40 game a season striker. This is why Man City want to possibly sign a younger player, a Harry Kane or a Erling Haaland. Both being linked with Man City, I can't see Aguero going to Arsenal. Ignore that, I couldn't even put his spell then. Chelsea are being strongly linked with Aguero. They have the money clearly to pay Aguero what he'd wish for. They have a decent manager in Thomas Tuchel. They have average strikers, if we're being honest, at Chelsea. You have Timo Werner, striker, stroke, winger, not done it at all for Chelsea so far. And definitely been a big flop there. They have Olivier Giroud, similar age to Aguero. Not the same type of player. And they have Tammy Abraham, who I believe will be sold this summer. I can't see him being happy to miss out on a place at the Euros if he does, and be nowhere near the Chelsea starting lineup. So I think Tammy Abraham probably moves on. Don't be surprised to see him at a West Ham next season, because I believe he's good enough for a club like West Ham, but not good enough for a team like Chelsea who want to win at the Champions League. The other team I would suggest for Aguero. Lifestyle over there, there wouldn't be as much pressure to sort of stuff in his first season, because Inter Miami are a new team. Napoli, I've also wrote here. Let's highlight some of these. Let's highlight the teams. So Napoli, I'm not sure if Aguero is still with the same lady, but he was at one point married, or at least going out with Diego Maradona's daughter. This was a lot of years ago, might have changed by since then. Could we see Aguero go to Napoli in honour of the late, great Diego Maradona? It's a possibility. As I said, I'm not sure if they're still together. Diego's daughter and Aguero, I couldn't tell you. Out of these, 1, 2, 4, 6 teams, I'm going to cross out Arsenal. I don't see the Arsenal deal happening. I don't see him going back to Atletico Madrid. I think if Atletico are going to do anything, if they do move on Suarez, it'll be for a younger striker, not a less mobile striker in Aguero. I think Chelsea will sign somebody, but I don't think it'll be Aguero. I would not be surprised to see them going for Danny Ings. You know, they spent a lot of money in the last transfer window. Can they afford to spend that again? I'm not sure. On a Haaland or an Mbappe or a Harry Kane. Yeah, we will get Harry Kane anyway, Chelsea. That leaves Napoli and the two Inter Milans. Well, Inter Miami and Inter Milan. I mean, he could go to a different club altogether. He could end up at Barrow Town, for all I know, or Chorley Athletic. I don't think he goes to Napoli. If I had these clubs in front of me now, Arsenal, Chelsea, Arsenal, Napoli, Inter Miami and Inter Milan, and I was told to put a tenner on any of these six clubs, I'd put a fiver on each of Inter Milan and Inter Miami. The Inter deal only happens, in my opinion, if Lukaku was to leave, and he is also being linked with a move to Man City. So maybe Lukaku goes to Man City, Aguero goes to Inter Milan. Let's keep that in our minds as we move on with the video and through the transfer window. Okay, next, let's pick another name off of our list. Okay, we're going to go for a defender, and one I watched play last night. Has been linked with him, or should we say, who was not being linked with Alaba. Chelsea. Ramos wherever he goes, even at United. Sergio Ramos would be a great signing for any club. Any of these clubs would be happy to have Ramos, and every other club would hate that that team has Ramos because he's a pain in the arse in the opposition team. But Alaba would be a capable replacement for Ramos, or an Alaba and Ramos centre back pairing for Real Madrid would also be very good. Liverpool, we've seen this season, they've relied on Nat Phillips, Ozan Kabak, the lad from Preston, who I don't think he's had a game, Ben Davies. A bit shitty, he might be inside him, they're not playing. Now Gomez, been injured most of the season. Van Dijk, injured pretty much all the season. If you'd had David Alaba there, you would not be relying on a Nat Phillips or a Kabak. And Alaba is free on a... well, he's available on a free transfer. Man United. I heard or read a really good stat the other day, which I was quite impressed with. Man United, since Harry Maguire signed for us, have conceded the second least amount of goals in the Premier League after... I'm not going to run down here. After Man City. Oh no, I've actually forgot to add. Man City to this list of possible teams for Alaba. Yeah, it's often said about United being bad defensively and Harry Maguire not being as value for money. He's actually a really good centre back, Harry Maguire, and that is a reason why United have conceded so few goals, especially during a time where we have no guaranteed number one goalkeeper. But Alaba alongside a Harry Maguire, that could be quite the partnership. United are definitely after a centre back, being linked with Jules Koundé at Sevilla, Konate at Leipzig, Upamecano before he signed for Bayern, Koulibaly at Napoli. Maybe a David Alaba free transfer would suit United. Man City have at times been linked with Alaba. He can play left back, he can also play centre back and midfield. Man City left back have João Cancelo. They also have Mendy, and they have Zinchenko. Alaba's experience of winning titles and Champions Leagues would be invaluable to Man City. I'd have to look at their squad, but I don't think there are many players in that team who have won a Champions League. I mean, think about it. Aguero hasn't. Foden hasn't. Sterling hasn't. Mahrez, no. Bernardo Silva, no. De Bruyne, no. I don't think there's many players at all in that Man City team who have ever won a Champions League. That's not to say they won't win it, but I don't think they have any players who have won it. Well, Alaba has. He could step in there and add that experience. PSG, they're always after looking to improve their team. I watched them against Bayern Munich of two legs. Marquinhos, fantastic, but went off injured in the first leg. I think they were relying on Kimpembe last night, and I can't remember who else. Since he lost Thiago Silva, though, they've not replaced him with a top quality defender. Could David Alaba be that one for PSG? Juve, love a free transfer, and Inter love a good deal. Juve have recently signed, in the last couple of seasons, players like Aaron Ramsey on a free transfer. Adrian Rabiot, I think they got on a free transfer, and various other players. Inter Milan, love a bargain. Look what they got Christian Eriksen for. Look what they got Alexis Sanchez for. Ashley Young. They had Victor Moses at one point. Okay, it's only on loan, but they'd love to do a good deal. That Signed.